As MPs play hide and seek with moneylenders and some get thrown in jail, voters are looking on bemused. MPs claim they are in debt because of demanding voters who each want a piece after they are elected into office. So they spend on burials, weddings, school fees for children and constituents, buy ambulances and the like. Some MPs have mused that they are free to return to their constituencies lest they be forced to become generous with money they do not have. We spoke to voters on what they think. Are they responsible for the MPs' woes? The MPs go for loans because they don't save while in parliament. And when time comes for campaigns, they begin going for loans to fund their politics. But we are not to blame.
I'm also a councillor. I went to the field and asked for support. People supported me at no cost. So it's not true that the people are the ones sending those MPs to borrow money that they bring it to them.
During times of campaigns, they bribe voters so that they can win, and this makes them accrue debts. And at the end, they fail to pay back. That's why they are arrested. Voters also accuse MPs of failing to deliver on their promises, which is why they demand that they at least part with something to make it better.
They should stop commercial politics, because it's easy to go to the public and you give them your manifesto. You give your manifesto to the voters, then they support you. It's easy than giving them money.
If all of them said, please, we are not giving any money, then the communities are going to be, you know, remodeled. They are going to model themselves and now run away, divert themselves from the politics of bribery to the politics of a better leader.
Gad Bender, the country director of World Voices Uganda, says the only way to stop the madness is for the government to abolish cash politics.
We need to ensure that bribery in elections is prohibited and punishable. Okay? It needs to ensure, I am happy that actually during campaigns, the issue of the law prohibits fundraising during campaigns. But for me, that's not also a solution. The issue is, do we have the community that have the capacity to build their own churches, to build their own schools, to build to do those critical services? Because we need spiritual healing.
Bender says MPs should make sure that the budget addresses issues that directly benefit the communities they serve, so voters don't call them to solve problems out of pocket.
So, for me, those could have been the issues that the MPs should have dealt with. So as long as you do not deal with those substantive issues, those critical issues, definitely the communities will continue demanding from the MPs. And therefore, the MPs will continue going to prison because they cannot sustain the leadership.
He wonders why some MPs should blame voters for getting on the wrong side of the law because of debts. He has also asked voters not to put their MPs on pressure.
Communities should be able to identify good leaders and even support them instead of milking them. Because at the end of the day, these leaders, when they go there, they have no time to work for them because they will be running away from money lenders. That's why some MPs actually don't go even to parliament, simply because they are fearing that any time the money lenders will arrest them. So when will they serve?
Report by Thomas Tumwebaze for the news.